Welcome to my quick tip, color scheme tiles. This is an exercise that's intended to be experimental and fun, and the end result produces this color scheme tile sheet, which can be a valuable resource for you. So I'm going to do this exercise on a quarter sheet of watercolor paper. You can do it on a smaller sheet if you want. You can do this on the back of, if you have some paintings you didn't finish or you have some scrap paper around, you can do this on the back. And while I've divided this into 15 squares, you can divide it into how many you want. This is a very flexible exercise. And what I've done is put two pieces of tape going across horizontally and four up and down, which gives me three rows and five columns. So I have 15 squares to work with. I'm going to begin placing color randomly across the entire sheet that I'm working on, and my board is at an angle, so as I start to spray this with water, which I'll do, it's going to help make this the colors flow and start to merge into one another. So I'm randomly putting this kind of a mauve tone down, and I'm not putting, when I do this, I'm not going to put every color in every square. There's going to be different color combinations. And my goal here is just to put these colors randomly and spray them with water and then let them move around the paper a little bit and start to merge. And once I've got to a point where I'm satisfied, then I'm going to dry the paper and take the tape off. And it's going to leave me these kind of interesting color mixtures and color schemes that I can use for reference when I'm working on other paintings, and I'll show you some examples of that. So you can see I'm using a variety of color here. I have yellows, I have blues, I have greens, I have reds. And the one thing to be aware of here is when you're doing this, if you do put complementary colors right beside each other and let them run into each other, you're going to get some neutrals pretty quick. So I'll get some neutrals in this, but for the most part, I'm trying to keep this kind of bright and colorful and give more of an influence with more color saturation and less neutrals in this this exercise. But there will be some complements near each other, and but I control how much is flowing around the paper and try not to let it get too neutral. As I continue to put some of these colors down, I'll just name some of the colors that I'm using. I have mauve, I have alizarin crimson, I have quinacridone gold, I have sap green, I have cobalt blue, I have cobalt turquoise. Let's see, maybe some ultramarine blue there. So quite a variety. I'm just taking colors off my palette, and I'm not doing this blindly. I am trying to look in some areas and match warms besides other warms and let them gradiate into one another. And here now I'm taking this spray bottle, and I am trying to spray this in a direction to try and get some kind of a directional flow across the whole paper, and that allows things the paint to flow a little bit from one block to the next. And this too is where you'll start to pick up some neutrals if you do have complements sitting beside each other, just because of the amount of water that lets them run around and then they'll merge together. But that's not necessarily a bad thing. It's just I'm trying to control it while I do this exercise, because again, I want it to be nice and colorful. And I've got pretty good coverage here, and one of the results here is that I have a lot of puddling going on the paper. So here I just take my brush, and all you have to do is touch your damp brush to paper, and it will pick up those little puddles of wash, and then just dry it off on a Kleenex or a towel. But this is a common technique when you're painting and working on your painting, and you start to get some puddling or pooling of water, Just take your brush and pick that up with just a damp brush. I've thoroughly dried this with a hairdryer and I'm going to pull up the tape. And as the tape comes off, you can see the border that's been created by protecting the paper in between these squares. So I have what I call a sheet full of color tiles. And I use these color schemes to sometimes, if I'm going to do a painting that's going to be more creative and not necessarily painting just local color of the scene, where I'm going to be creative, have a creative color scheme, I'll use these for reference and I'll look through my sheets and see if there's a scheme that I like, and then I'll use those colors to develop my painting. Now you could be very scientific with this if you want and do analogous color schemes or triads or split triads, but here in this example I just randomly took paint off my palette and just let it gradate into one another, and it creates an interesting effect. So here's a close-up look at the color tiles with a picture taken under brighter lights with an SLR camera. You can see some nice rich colors. You have some tiles leaning towards the cool side and others leaning towards the warm side. But this is intended to be a reference tool that you can use to try and spark some ideas when you're trying to be a little bit more creative with your painting process. Now here's a floral of mine that takes a similar color scheme to one of these tiles and incorporates it into this floral painting. And the same is true for this cityscape, which has maybe a color scheme that you wouldn't think of if you're setting out to do a cityscape. So again, a variety of subjects you can use this approach. And this is a landscape with some buildings. And again, and not necessarily local color, but it's an interesting color scheme, makes for an interesting composition. And that's my exercise for making color tiles. If you do decide to give this a try, I hope you enjoy it and have fun with it. And as always, if you have questions, you can reach me at contactrsherwitzart@gmail.com. You can follow me on Facebook. And if you enjoy this, don't forget to like it, share it, and comment. Thanks for watching.